Okay, so this is the start of a video series about writing Bluetooth low energy apps for mobile phones. In this first video, I will go over some important terms, concepts, and general things you'll want to be aware of before you get started, so you don't get lost in future videos. If you're super knowledgeable and already know about Bluetooth low energy, cool. Skip the next video or something. I don't know what to tell you. If you don't know what the heck I'm talking about, then stick around and I will briefly guide you through the wonderful world of Bluetooth Low Energy. So, the first thing you need to understand is that Bluetooth Low Energy and traditional Bluetooth are similar, but not quite the same thing. They have different purposes, and you'll need to consider use cases for both of them before you get started on any kind of project. Traditional Bluetooth, the kind you're likely familiar with, is the kind you would find in wireless headphones, speakers, keyboards, mice, cars, or really any type of device where the size and the amount of data being transferred is reasonably large. These days, batteries of traditional Bluetooth devices tend to last a while, but sometimes they die at inconvenient times. BLE, on the other hand, is designed to do exactly what its name implies: be low energy. BLE achieves this by emitting small amounts of data once every few milliseconds or longer at a short range. This is different from traditional Bluetooth, which maintains a constant connection at all times. BLE is not really intended to be used for two-way communications, but if you really want to, you can set it up that way. You just might not get as much energy savings as you were thinking you would. This method allows coin cell-sized batteries in some BLE designs to last for not just hours, but also days, months, and even years. Traditional Bluetooth doesn't come close to this battery life, and that's why BLE is so exciting. Right now, BLE is mostly being used for what is called beacons. You can look at Estimote, Gimbal, Onyx, Stick and Find for some good real-world examples. Basically, there's small power battery-powered devices that are designed to be wirelessly read by a mobile device to create a context-aware experience for the user. A store using beacons might set some of them up around a bunch of products and recommend customers use their app to interface with those beacons. If the user opened up in their app in front of a pair of shoes near a set of beacons that were assigned to the shoe, the store's app on the phone would use data from the beacon to display information about the shoe, and again, give the customer a context-aware mobile experience. And one other neat BLE application I can think of off the top of my head for you Apple fans is iOS AirDrop. If you don't already know what that is, it is a wireless protocol that iOS devices can use to transfer files between each other without a Wi-Fi or mobile data connection. And it actually uses Bluetooth Low Energy to establish that Wi-Fi-less, mobile data-less connection between two devices. There are a bunch of other neat BLE applications I've seen, but this video is already getting kind of long, and I'm sure y'all just want to get started ASAP on writing the app, so I'll stop right there and we'll continue in the next video.